Today is the lecture 9 of Basic Electronics with the topic half-wave rectifier part 3.
So let's begin with our today's lecture, and today's lecture is the half-wave rectifier part 3. Today we will know about half-wave rectifier's efficiency and PIV, that is the peak inverse voltage. Okay, so first topic is our efficiency. Definition: it is defined as ratio of DC power available at the load to the input AC ratio. Basically, see, efficiency is denoted by eta. This N type of thing is we denote is as eta, and as it is say, it is defined as ratio of DC power. So it is the ratio of the P load by P in. Okay. This P load is the power available at the load, and hence it is the ratio of the DC power available at the load, okay, and to the input AC power. So P in is the AC power. See, I have denoted P load as power available at the load and P in as input AC power, okay. We know that power is equal to voltage into current, and voltage we can also write as current into resistance. So if we substitute the value of V in this equation, that is P is equal to VI, then P is equal to I square R, right? We can write P load as I square DCR. Why? Because this is the DC power, right? So we know that power of the load can be written as I square DCR. And P in is the AC power. We have also studied this one, that I square RMS. RMS means root mean square, right? So as we know, P is equal to I square R. So we can denote P load as I square DCR and P in as I square RMS R. Okay. And into 100%, because we will take out the efficiency, and efficiency is always in percentage. As R and R is same, so we will cut both of this, okay. Now I square DC, we know that I DC is equal to Im by pi. We have done in the previous parts of half wave rectifier, and I RM is equal to Im by 2, right? So we will substitute this two here, that is I as I square DC. So it will be I square M by pi square. So if we write I square M by pi square here, and I RMS as Im by 2, so here it will be I square M, and by 4, so here it will be by 4, so it will go up, reciprocal it will be. So I square M is same, so we will cut I square M and I square M. So we left with what? So we are left with 4 by pi into 100%, and when we solve this one, we will get 40.56%, and hence this is the very low efficiency of the half wave rectifier, and this is the disadvantages of the half wave rectifier, because its efficiency is very low. When we will do the full wave rectifier, we will get the difference. Okay, now we will move on to the PIV. Now we will do this PIV. PIV means peak inverse voltage. PIV is also known as PRV. First, we will read the definition. What is PIV? Maximum reverse bias voltage that can be applied across the diode before entering to the zener or the breakdown voltage. See, when we get zener or breakdown voltage in the reverse bias of the diode, right? So here we made the circuit with a diode and a voltage, and this voltage is denoted as VM, and here one resistor, but we will change this diode to open circuit. Okay, this is the equivalent circuit. So here the voltage will move from positive to negative, right? And as it is open circuit, there will be no current flow. That means I is equal to zero, and the resistance voltage, that is the V out, will be also equal to zero because there is no current flow. And now we will solve this equivalent circuit with the help of the KVL. With the help of what? With the help of KVL, that is Kirchhoff's voltage law, which is also known as loop rule. See, we also know that KVL means whenever the voltage will move from positive to negative, we will take it as negative. So we wrote as minus Vm. Okay. And whenever it will move from negative to positive, we will take it as positive. So it will be positive of V equal to 0. And here PIV is equal to V. Remember, this V which we are finding is our PIV. So when we solve this equation, we get V is equal to Vm. So what does it mean? PIV is equal to V equal to Vm. That is, this voltage is equal to this. But there is a condition in this peak inverse voltage. What is it? That PIV must always be greater than equal to Vm. Why so? If this one will be greater than PIV, if this one will be greater than PIV, then the diode will get damaged, which will lead to not getting the output. So for the protection of the diode, PIV must always be greater than equal to Vm. Okay. So today's lecture ends here. What we get to know about today's lecture, we get to know about efficiency and the peak inverse voltage of half-wave rectifier. So we will see you in the next lecture, and thank you for watching.
Now it's the code time. Better late than never. I hope all of you understood today's lecture, and thank you for watching.
Wow, that's impressive. You have completed a magic today. For more videos, subscribe. Join our Facebook group and Instagram page for group discussion and live magus videos for exam preparation in an hour. We start at class like community for students to learn from a friend in a simple way and support them in their own languages. If you are willing to be that one friend who saves us at the exam night preparation, then please join us by visiting classfly.in.